The regulations outlining the use of remotely piloted aircraft systems or drones are outlined in the Remotely Piloted Aircraft Systems Regulations of 2017. These regulations can be downloaded from the KCA website, which is indicated on the screen. They can also be downloaded from this website under the tab of resources and regulator documents. The regulations define various categories of drones. First of all, the drones which are less than 2 kilograms of weight are considered to be toys. This is provided that these drones do not have any powering by a fuel system, they are not capable of carrying any payload, they are not fitted with a camera, they are operated at less than 50 feet above the ground level, they operate at less than 50 meters from the operator, and they are operated at less than 18.5 kilometers per hour. So such devices do not require the approval of the authority so as to operate, and they can be freely operated. Some of the highlights of the regulations: all operation of drones must be within the visual line of sight. This of course gives a very drastic limitation, because it means that the drones cannot be used for transportation of goods between two different locations. And indeed, it limits the usage of drones to things like filming and agricultural uses, for example in the case of crop dusting. It's expected that as the technology matures, this will be reviewed. Secondly, all drone operations should be carried out only during daylight. There's a provisions for asking for waivers in specific situations. Drones must yield way to other aircraft, and this is quite important because this touches on a fundamental safety issue. The drones must not be flown in negligent or reckless operations. This is according to regulation number 13. The regulation further explains what is meant by negligent and reckless operation. Such operations are operations that endanger other aircraft, persons, or property in the course of operation, or operation in or around a prohibited or restricted airspace. Restricted and prohibited airspace are usually outlined within the Aeronautical Information Publication, AIP, which is published by the KCAA. So it means that you should be familiar with this publication, and also you should be familiar with the regular publications which are issued by KCAA, for example, NOTAMs, which means Notice to Airmen. The third description of negligent and reckless operation is that this is operation which takes place in or around strategic locations, radar sites, high tension cables and communication masts, prisons, police stations, courts of law, and scenes of crime. These are all geared towards ensuring security and safety. And the regulator looks very seriously upon this, and there's a very hefty fine for non-compliance. There's also a provision that your drone should not be used in the carriage of dangerous goods. Dangerous goods are also usually defined by the Kenya Civil Aviation Authority, and it's also listed, and this is in regulation number 14. So dangerous goods refer to chemical or biological substances, nuclear material, explosives, arms, ammunitions, and munitions of war, corrosive substances, radioactive elements, volatile liquids, highly flammable liquids, aerosol sprays, and any other material which shall be classified as dangerous by the authority. You need the authority of KCA in order to operate your drone. And the regulation also indicates how you are supposed to get this authorization. The regulation defines three categories of drones. Of course, the first category we have said is that the ones which are lighter than 2 kilograms are considered to be toys and do not fall under the regulation. Then three other categories are defined. The first is the drones which are used for recreation and sports. The second category is the drones which are for private use. And the third category are drones which are intended for commercial use. The stringency of the regulation is progressive as you move from recreation and sports through private use to commercial use. And indeed, for commercial use, you require something almost similar to what is required for the pilot of a manned aircraft.